I'm Guillaume Sabourin, and I will be telling you about the 17 most widely used camera angles and shots in the world of cinema, through examples in films. So please sit back and relax as you watch this instructional video. The first shot I would like to talk about is the establishing shot. The establishing shot sets up or establishes the setting of a scene. It is typically at the beginning of a movie or scene. In this movie, Vertical Limit, it says that the setting is in a canyon. Over here, we have a close-up shot. A close-up shot tightly frames a person or object to show detail or emotion. In this movie, we have a medium shot. A medium shot is shot from waist or knees up from a medium distance. It generally shows more body language and less specific detail. Similar to an establishing shot, we have a long shot. A long shot shows the entire figure or object, often in relation to its surroundings. It is typically filmed far from the object. Similar to a dolly shot, which I will be telling you about later, we have a tracking shot. A tracking shot follows the action at a constant distance. It keeps the subject on screen at all times. Another very widely used shot is the aerial shot. The aerial shot shows the entire image from a high position. It's sometimes referred to as a bird's eye view shot. In this movie, The Panic Room, a dolly shot is used. A dolly shot is when a camera is placed on a dolly and moves at a constant rate. It does not necessarily follow the action. In this 1958 movie, a handheld shot is used. A handheld shot is filmed from the cameraman's own hands, therefore it is a little shaky. It can be used to show the subject's perspective or feeling. This demonstration is known as a zoom shot. A zoom shot either zooms in to isolate the subject or zooms out to show it in a wider context. In this shot, it zooms into the object from the universe. In this comedic act, a swish pan shot is used. A swish pan moves the camera from one subject to another very quickly. In this movie, the technique used to film this man is known as a high angle shot. In a high angle shot, the camera is located above the subject and films down on it. It's sometimes used to show which character is more powerful. 32, male, Austin. A reverse angle is often used to film a conversation between two or more characters. A reverse angle switches between the two or more subjects in a dialogue scene. It's shot from the other side of the subject.
Things can get pretty crazy, right?
Yeah, I guess so.
The technique used to film this man is known as a low angle. A low angle is typically shot from knees up. It can also show the power of a character in a conversation. A good example of an arc shot would be the 20th Century Fox clip. In an arc shot, the camera moves around the object in a circular motion in order to show the image from more angles. Over here, we have a match cut. A match cut joins two scenes that have some relationship seamlessly together, as if they were in the same scene. In this movie, Shooter, we have a point of view shot. In a point of view shot, the camera shows the scene from a character's perspective. Basically, you see through the character's eyes. The last shot that I would like to talk about is a head-on shot. A head-on shot is when the action comes straight to the camera. Well, that sums it up for the day. Thank you very much for watching.